shots, which in the end told the full story.
And here, of course, at Prospect Oval, we are three-quarter time. 27-point ball game in favour of the Tigers. Looking at last quarter stats, Glenelg have won 6 out of their 9 last quarters, whereas North Adelaide, Zach, have only won 3. So the job's certainly ahead of the Roosters at the final change.
That's interesting for a side that's in the top two of the ladder too, isn't it,
Phil? Yep. So, umpire Crosby just making sure the ground is all clear. Holds the footy aloft and we're underway in the final term. 30 minutes of footy left in round 10. And James Craig up against Hanneth. Hanneth just tries to keep the footy in the area. James Craig did well. Snook applying a tackle as Matty Snook always does.
Just ferocious, isn't he, Matty Snook? He's never out of the contest.
Amazing to think a couple of years ago he was toiling away in the reserves. He's now a two-time best and fairest Jack Odie medalist and a premiership player. As LeBoy's there from the stoppage.
Clever.
A deft little tap was nice there to Harrison Wigg, who off the left boot. Well, that's as rare.
Yeah.
Well, as you'll see,
he just hadn't quite steadied his body to kick there. Needed probably 2 more paces and he would have nailed the kick, but very, really clever by LeBoy's to knock it over to him.
Yeah, rare error there from Harrison Wigg, the boy from Walkerville. His kick went out of bounds on the full. Curry's there from Agnew, sat under it, 2 players down, including the aforementioned Agnew. Finlay, the Roosters player, as North will try and go forward. Glenelg, rather, doing well. Weir there, dispossessed in a tackle, holding the ball. Great tackle, Tanner Smith. So Wigg has another opportunity to make amends. His kick over the top there of his teammate in Mitch Harvey, through the hands there of Keenan Ramsey. Slade did well for Glenelg defensively. He'll find Park, who now gives it back to Snook, who goes back to Park, who was fronted there by Robbie Young.
Oh, that's...
And a free kick, or a mark's been paid. So it was a strong mark in the end by Weir.
Courageous. And as we see that mark taken, Brad Agnew limping from the field for Glenelg. That doesn't look good at all. Can't put weight on his foot.
Yeah, body blow for the Tigers, who have already been one down most of the contest with Neil Vivi out injured. As Weir takes it, he's taken the ground by Moore in a tackle. And it'll be a free kick to the Tigers. Moore won't be happy, nor will the North faithful. And Weir didn't even realise it was his free kick. So the young man from Robe, right in front of the interchange bench, holds the footy aloft. Some kind of set play, you would suspect. Down the line he goes with the kick. Coming in there, Reynolds takes the mark, rather. I thought it might have been touched by the man in front there, his teammate in Condon. But yeah. Reynolds gets onto that left boot, goes inside 50, in some space, and all alone is Stretch.
That was a superb pass from Luke Reynolds. Saw Stretch in some open space on the fat side. As we just see here, Phil, Tom Condon coming to the bench looking a little bit proppy after that marking contest. So the Tigers are dropping like flies here early in the fourth term.
A war of attrition for Glenelg's interchange. Can they keep up with the injuries? As Billy Stretch now is lining up, kicking to goal down at the southern or Robron end. Get to score a goal this afternoon. Comes in now, leans back on it, gets underneath it. It's moving across the face, through for a minor score. So the first score of the final term is a behind. Glenelg, 10-11-71. North Adelaide, 6-7-43.
That would have been huge for the Tigers to strike first there. We saw them do that in the second term when they were going into the breeze.
So Wigg took the kick out. Went to former Ross Trevor boy in Alex Spina. Gives it back in a hand pass now to Wigg. He'll now kick down the line looking for Will Coomey. Got in the good position against his opponent in Motlop, but dropped the mark. Ball spills out now to Virgin, and then Park's in there as well. Hender comes in and gives it back to Will Coombe, inside 50, setting a task for Ramsey. Proud with a great desperate effort, and spoils the ball over the boundary line.
It was a lovely kick by Will Coombe there, just to sit it out on the wide side for Ramsey to run onto, but and just as good a spoil by Max Proud to reach around and get it over the boundary line.
Well, it's thrown in left forward pocket down at the Farmer or northern end. Hanneth up against Harvey, coming through there, Moore. Surgeon would have asked for more from his charges there at three-quarter time, and Andrew kicks truly. Much-needed goal for the Roosters, and they go to 7-7-49. Glenelg, 10-11-71. 4 minutes gone in the final term, an important goal for North Adelaide, Zach.
Particularly, sort of two-goal turnaround, isn't it? Billy Stretch misses that set shot to Glenelg's end, and then classic piece of roving there from Andrew Moore. We've seen him do that many a time before. And a really nice finish with a snapshot from about 35 metres out in front. North Adelaide strike first and get themselves up and about here early in the last quarter.
So, good goal to Moore, the 29-year-old. Played 55 games with the Power and was, of course, aligned to the Roosters back in 2010 through to 2013. We'll jump at number 44 back then. as Glenelg will look to go through the clearance. The hand pass there put Partington under pressure. The North fans wanted holding the ball. They've turned the footy over now, have North Adelaide. They've got it now through the avenue of Chalmers. His floating kick to half forward. Inside 50 go the Roosters with a bit of momentum. Mitch Harvey with a hand pass to Schwartz. He's got a teammate flanking him in Ullman. The ball didn't quite sit. In the end, for Stretch, it went over his head. And Ullman on hands and knees gets a hand pass out, but he's flooded down there by a sea of Tigers. And the kick comes out, though, intercepted beautifully by Spina. Can it be a captain's goal? Alex Spina kicks from outside 50. And a fantastic finish from Spina. And back-to-back goals for North Adelaide. They go to 8-7-55. Back to a 16-point deficit. 10-11-71 Glenelg. 5 minutes gone. And the Roosters chant is up and about. Zach Milbank.
Here they come, North Adelaide. That is for sure a really fierce attack of the football by the captain, Alex Spina, there. Met the ball on the half volley, let fly from about 50 out and let the breeze do the rest, and a really quality finish. And a couple of early goals is exactly what North Adelaide would have been after, just to get themselves right into the game and also the crowd.
Yeah, within 5 minutes, the deficit's been cut from 27 points just down to the 16, as I said. So North with some momentum. Can Glenelg counter-attack North Adelaide's forward pressure coming through? James Craig with a hit out down there to Chalmers. Got it from Moore. Hanneth with a nice little intercept. Then Allen with a high up and under kick. Sitting under to Ullman. Courageously takes a great mark. Jared Ullman with great courage. And the boy from Two Worlds took a strong mark.
Just saw the breeze. Just how strong that is there. Matty Allen's kick certainly held up in it.
So Ullman spots up a teammate there on the outer side in Jarman. He uses the ball well inside 50. Commentator's curse, and Ben Jarman's kicked it out of bounds on the full.
Once again to that outer side too.
Yeah, and the breeze again having an impact on it. So the resulting free kick in the left back pocket will go to Michael Virgin. He's got the fluoro pink boots on. Kicks down the line. Reynolds flew. Ball spills to ground level. Hard up against the line. Nicholson went towards the line. Well done by Partington though to keep it in play. And he's high up and under kick sitting under the breeze. And well done there by Spina. Judge the flight of it better. Gives it off there to Wick. His kick was partially smothered. Trying the attempted soccer out of midair was Ullman. Follows up with a chase down from behind against McBean, but Nicholson has the footy. He'll square it up. Sits it up for a teammate there. Well done by Cam Craig. Won the one-on-one. Gets it out now towards his teammate there in Jarman. But coming through, Agnew did well. In fact, it was Bailey rather. And then Cam Craig again involved. Moore in there as well. Just jams it on the boot. North try and repel it and go forward. Coming through LeBoys. He just puts it on the boot and goes inside 50. Can it sit for Hender? Great trap against his former club. Louis tries the don't argue. Gets around his opponent. Inside 50. Looking for Ramsey. He went to ground. North's forwards trying to keep it in. But well done by Glenelg's defence. And the pressure there comes out through Allen. He spots up Weir on this broadcast side. He's got not much ahead of the ball. And Weir will go short and find McBean. That was a well-weighted kick. Liam McBean has marked true centre wing broadcast side.
He did well just to hesitate on the lead there, McBean. Make sure he had plenty of space to lead into on that wing. As we see Tom Condon back on after that, looking a little bit proper earlier in that quarter.
Right on cue. Takes the mark in front of the interchange bench. So the former double blue kicks down the line.
Reynolds
sits there
space.
For Reynolds. And the Ooh. Space was good. That should be a free kick, if not the mark paid. James Craig a little overzealous there with the nudge. Again, you would think Reynolds too far out to score. He gets a lead down there from his teammate. Goes inside 50, does Reynolds. Flying at the back there, Tanner Smith. The captain of the Roosters does well with some composure. Spina with a hand pass there to Ullman on the non-preferred right. It comes back out to Davies. Gives it now to Zekely. He gets around his opponent, then he squares it up in board. That's a beautiful pass. He's found Will Coombe. He want to roll onto that left boot. He's going to switch it to this grandstand side. The North should be able to move forward with the overlap. Off the mark now of LeBoys. He goes on the left boot and kicks forward and finds Young.
Glenelg had got back really well there, Phil. Even though they got the corridor kick, they've forced North Adelaide wide here.
16-point deficit, 9 minutes gone in the final term. As Max Proud, in fact Luke Parks rather, with a disciplined spoil over the boundary line. So 8-7-55 the Roosters. Glenelg 10-11-71. 9 gone in the final term. Phil Aspinall, Zach Milbank, bringing you all the highlights and action on the digital pass. Ball will be hurled back into play. Left forward pocket. Hanneth with a hit out. The boys first to it though. Gets a boot to ball quickly inside 50. Nicholson with a bit of a worm burner. He take it at the toes. No, said the umpire. And Schwartz applies a good tackle.
It was one of those slips catches which I think grazed the grass as he clasped it, Phil.
He's just getting up a little properly, Zach, and he's clutching at the collarbone. So Cole Nicholson might have just copped a bit of a knock when he went to ground.
Bit of a stinger, maybe.
As up goes the footy. Craig and Hanneth, well done by Hanneth. Won the hit out, looking down there for Stretch. He just threads his way through some traffic, but the quick kick's going to be intercepted and marked there by Ben Jarman, who's probably played one of his best games at league level for mine. So Ben Jarman, called to play on. He'll bang it inside 50, down to the teeth of goals. Hender flies at the back. Could he take it? No. Hanneth jams it on the boot, just clearing defensive 50 for the moment. Coming in board now with a hand pass. Puller needs to do something with it. Got the handball out. Darcy Bailey under a bit of pressure. Well done by Campbell Coombe and LeBoys. We'll have another stoppage.
Only Liam McBean and Cameron Craig ahead of the centre circle for Glenelg at the moment.
Well, the whistle's gone from the throw-up. It's going to be a free kick there to the Tigers. So Jack Hanneth, recipient of. He gets a lead from the aforementioned McBean. Comes to this broadcast side. Flew early, didn't quite take it. In the hands now of Miller, the former Magpie. Kick was partially smothered. Well done, Jarman. Frees the hands. Gives it off there to Cam Craig. Gives it back in a 1-2 from Davies. Kicks towards Mitch Harvey. He's had a quiet day by his standards. Proud can mop up defensively in some space. He'll chip short and find Allen. And it was a good mark by the former West Coast Eagle. So they just need to take their time now, Glenelg. They've got a 16-point lead. 11 minutes gone in this final term as the breeze holds up that Allen kick and flying and taking a nice mark there. Reynolds
read the flight of it really well, knew it was going to drop short and sort of caught Carl Finlay out a little bit there. Luke Reynolds, that's his experience.
Yeah, I reckon the Glenelg forwards have done that better than their counterparts, judging the flight better, as the restless Roosters fans want play on to be called as Reynolds will kick down the line. McBean surely hanging on to his opponent. That free kick certainly missed for mine, as now North Adelaide will clear from the defensive half. Patrick Davies, the first game with a high up and under kick. Bradley dropped what he should have taken. Park's there to mop up. Now to Proud. His short chipping ball's a good one, and he'll spot up Callum Park. So we're in the long sleeve. Callum Park, a former junior Australian baseball player. He'll chip short and find Andrew Bradley.
Will he switch this here? Be interesting. No, he's going to head down the line.
The boy from Kyleby Byelight kicks down the line, as Zach said. And Reynolds again almost took a good mark. Good body work there at the front position. Coming through Weir. He's been pinged holding the ball. Tried to do too much.
And just as we say that, Marlon Motlop's gone to ground clutching his right leg. It doesn't look like he's looking too good there, Phil.
Glenelg could have no one on the bench as North on their counter-attack. Ball sat for Miller. The former Magpie kicks the goal. Keanu Miller has kicked it. Here come the Roosters. Miller gets his first. And it's a 10-point ball game. 9-7-61 North Adelaide. Glenelg 10-11-71. 12 and a half gone final term. The Tigers are out on their feet, literally, Zach. And here come the Roosters.
Yeah, lovely finish by Keanu Miller. You can't leave him in so much space like that. He's got pace to burn. Nailed it on the run from 35 metres in front. So a really quality finish. As Marlon Motlop limps to the bench, he's off now, being inspected. Sort of looks like his ankle without obviously knowing at this very early stage. But, Glenelg, certainly the walking wounded, trying to hobble across the line and protect this lead, as they need to at least score one, maybe two more goals to win this, Glenelg. So they can't go too defensive.
Keanu Miller, his first goal on the afternoon. He's been reinvigorated as a running halfback, the boy from Portland. As we're back in the middle, it should be a secondary stoppage. Mitch Harvey claiming a free for holding the ball. Jack Hanneth on the bottom of the pack. So 10-point ball game. Glenelg led by as much as 27 points at three-quarter time. North with all the momentum in this final term. Again, they'll go forward. Chalmers against his former club, keeps it low. Goes into the forward pocket, looks for and finds Robbie Young. So left forward pocket on the wrong side for a left footer. And Robbie Young down there. Hard up against the boundary line fence.
Seen him do check sides from here, though, Phil. But the other one is, that wouldn't surprise me, is if he even played on and did a nice little balk.
Well, he's looking to open up the angle on the non-preferred right. Robbie Young, has he kicked it? No. Ooh. Holy moly, that would have been a good goal.
Great effort on his non-preferred, as you say.
Single-digit deficit now, 9 points the margin. 14 gone in the final term.
Neil Vivi back on the ground.
He's back.
He's been put up into attack. So at least putting his body out there to try and help Glenelg numbers-wise.
As you said, the walking wounded. And VV, another one of the SANFL players that dates a SANFL W player, Sophie Armistead at Norwood, his girlfriend.
Oh, huge kick this.
There's this one, a dangerous kick for Glenelg. The kick across the face of goal. The goal kicker in Miller's intercepted. Gives it to Hender. He'll blaze towards goal. A helicopter punt. How's the bounce? It's wobbling through for a minor score. Hender there with two goals, one now on the day. 14 and three quarter minutes gone, rather.
He was waiting for the Angus Monfries leg spinner then, wasn't he? Sometimes the ball can do that.
Yeah, the unique facet of our oval-shaped ball. So 63 North Adelaide. Glenelg 10-11-71 as the Tigers go to that outer side. Chopped off again, though, by North inside 50. And Park with some composure. The young man takes a nice mark. Left back pocket. And at the farmer end, we've gone 15 minutes. 9-point ball game. 8 points, rather, as the kick out there from Park. He'll go to that outer side again. And McBean takes an easy mark. Judge the flight of the ball again better. And you can just see his intention just to slow the game down.
Once again, attacking on that outer side, Phil. Both teams have done it all day long there with the wind.
McBean, the former Richmond Tiger, kicks down the line. A good mark from Finlay. Impressive mark by the youngster from Corn. The kick wasn't so impressive. He set up a task there for Wig. But he's got Cam Craig in some space. He'll then go back to the aforementioned Finlay, who juggled the mark. He goes short and he's got a lead there from Allman. And Jared Allman's marked on the halfback position out of side. He'll come in board and find Miller. He's got chased down there from behind by VV, but Miller too quick. He'll bang it inside 50. Where's Louis? There's Louis! Judge the flight of the footy better against Luke Park. And a good mark from Louis Hender. And he's about 12 metres out on a slight angle. And North Adelaide, Zach, with all the momentum.
They have indeed. And they're moving the ball through the corridor really nicely. When they're getting that ball at half-back, they're looking for that 45 kick into the centre square. And, Keanu Miller getting plenty of cheers from the North Adelaide faithful as he comes onto the bench.
And Hender kicks his third. Here come North Adelaide. A three-point game. 10-9-69. Glenelg 10-11-71, so a two-point ball game, 17 gone in the final turn. You hear the Roosters chant, and it is the walking wounded for the Tigers, Zach. Can they hang on?
Yeah, not unless they kick one, if not two, more goals here, Phil. They do need to score, because at the moment they sort of, as you say, look like they're sitting ducks with the injury problems, and North Adelaide with the breeze at their back and their momentum, the crowd's into it now. You can really sense the change of complexion on this match.
23 goals on the season now for Hender. So North Adelaide in this final term have managed to kick four goals and have kept Glenelg to just one behind. Just waiting for the players to reset for this final term. And it's going to be a warning against Glenelg.
Yep.
Matty Allen just didn't quite get into position. So the next indiscretion will be a free against the Tigers. Underway in the middle. Clearance going the way of Glenelg through Partington. The McGarry medalist kicks towards half forward. Ball spills out the back. Well judged, though, by the player in Jarman. He'll kick to half forward. Needs to sit for Davies. Did well. He's strong over the contest. He's wrapped up, though, by Billy Stretch. And we'll have a ball up on that outer side half forward line. So a two-point ball game. 10-9-69, the Roosters. Glenelg 10-11-71. As from the stoppage, we see Partington put himself over the footy, but North Adelaide will go forward through Moore. He'll kick inside 50, and Parks again with a good mark. Again, courageously sat under it, not knowing what was coming. Copped an ear bashing for his trouble. And he'll chip short and go laterally to find Callum Park. So Parks to Park. Park now for the Tigers. Should kick down the line to that centre wing outer side position. McBean flies, fisted over the boundary line it goes. So we'll have another throw in. 18 and a half gone final term. Round 10 SANFL statewide Super League action. A thriller here at Prospect. Phil Aspinall, Zach Milbank, your commentary team, as we see a change for the Roosters. Ormond off.
They're rotating quite heavily at the moment, really trying to expose the fact that Glenelg's under the pump with their injuries, Phil.
Kim Lebois with fresh legs comes on as from the throw in. James Craig won the hit out, but taken there by Darcy Bailey. Got a hand pass of sorts out, but well done by Schwarz for North Adelaide. Gets it in board to Moore. He's dispossessed in a tackle and holding the ball it is. So a chance now for Glenelg. And Billy Stretch, the recipient of the free. It was a strong tackle by the former Melbourne Demon. Just backward of centre wing on that outer side. Glenelg with that 2-point advantage. Led by as much as 27 points at three-quarter time. And a stretch kick, not a good one. Set a task there for Partington. Good spoil by Campbell Coombe. Hard up against the line, well done by Zekely. Kept it in play. North again will go forward. Moore goes to ground. Hender there up against Parks, who was up to the task, did really well. Off now to Sharonberg. He's inside defensive 50. Short chipping ball. Numbers there for Glenelg. They could have raffled it, but the ball didn't quite see it. North's forwards doing well to try and force the turnover, and they've done so. Hender's kick was smothered by Park. Then Park's kick was smothered by Will Coombe. Ball ricochets out towards the boundary line and goes over for a throw-in. So hotly contested battle there, Zach.
Perfect example of how North Adelaide's got their tails up at the moment. They just swarmed the Tigers there. Glenelg just managed to hold on and prevent the scoring opportunity. The
intensity level's gone up a notch as the ball's thrown back into play. Left half forward, Hanif unopposed. Won the hit out down to Partington, who jams it on the boot, kicks it towards centre winger McBean, takes a strong mark. I've enjoyed that battle all day, McBean up against Cam Craig.
He's got VV one-on-one with Finlay, but looks like he's going to wait for some other Tigers to flood back.
So VV creates the lead, gets into some space and tries the outstretched mark, couldn't quite take it, spills over the back to Cooler. He's got nothing inside 50, his hand pass intercepted there by Jarman, well done also by Wigg. Kick around the corner for Cam Craig, can he take it cleanly? Handball's back in board to Moore, he needs to be clean. Back now with a hand pass, North have some numbers. Off there to Wigg, he's just going to throw it on the boot, kick it down the line, and Reynolds will fist it over for a throw-in. So it wasn't pretty, but North just trying to repel it forward. 21 minutes gone in the final term, a two-point ball game. Glenelg 10-11-71, North Adelaide 10-9-69.
Luke Reynolds playing an interesting defensive role, roaming around there at the defensive side of the contest.
So ball thrown in, clearance goes the way of the Tigers. The aforementioned Reynolds with a high up and under kick. McBean outnumbered. Was he nudged off the footy? Umpire said no. Ball towards the boundary line. Well done by Weir. Kept it in. Kept it alive. Goes inside to Darcy Bailey. Inside 50. VV and Finlay. Finlay did well. Ball spills out the back. Gives it back now to his teammate Zekely. Off there to Wigg, who had a touch of the fumbles. Was he taken high? Yes, he was. Again, the non-officiating umpire spotted it. And Wigg, quick to move the footy, goes to that outer side. North now with some numbers and a chance to go forward. Spina sees the boy, a teammate in board in Schwarz. Needs to take the mark. He couldn't. Tapped it on to Zekely. Over the top now to Schwarz. He then decapitated Cooler. Certainly a free kick every day of the week. And Neil Cooler put his head over the footy, won the free. He'll go short now and just try and calm things down through Virgin.
You can see the contrast in the styles. North Adelaide playing on an all contest, using their pace and speed. Glenelg holding it up.
So Virgin kicks down the line to the scoreboard pocket, and a mark's been paid. It's going to go the way of the captain of the Roosters in Alex Spina, former Crows rookie. The teacher from Ross Trevor. He gets called to play on. He'll kick down the line. Craig and Hannathan are one-on-one. Park flies from the back, coming through proud. He's wrapped up by Tanner Smith, the former Docker, and we'll have a ball up.
Great attack on the footy from the captain there, Maxie Proud.
Was indeed. 22 and a half gone. Still plenty of time in this contest. A chance now for North to go forward through Moore. But that kick behind play, as Zach's touched on, through Reynolds.
Switched to Partington on his own. Just came off the bench. In fact, had the headset on a minute ago to Mark Stone.
Perfect timing for the interchange there as Partington kicks down the line. Good body position there from Cam Craig up against McBean. And coming now through halfback is Moore. Wigg's taken the mark under some pressure there from Partington. So Harry Wigg is going to kick down the line. He gets a lead there from Hender. Parks flies. Good spoil down there from Hender. Did well to keep the ball alive. A hand pass out into some space. Keeping his feet there was Ramsey, but the ball ricocheted over the boundary line.
Exceptional tackle from Jonty Sharonberg there, making sure Louis Hender didn't break through, because that would have caused a certain scoring opportunity for North.
Four goals in this final term. We're about to tick into the 24-minute mark. You'd think maybe 2 or 3 minutes of play left. Ball thrown back in. Down at the North Adelaide kicking end. They're going to that northern end. Campbell Coombe went to throw it on the boot, but saw he was up against the line. And we'll have a throw in. So hearts in your mouth stuff. 23 and a half gone.
There must be a reasonable amount of time left, because I haven't seen Glenelg put out their 5-minute warning sign yet, Phil. So
good spot there, Zach, as the ball's thrown in. Hanneth with a hit out. Down though to Chalmers for North Adelaide. Sockering it off the ground there and tapping it to his own advantage. Spina. Moore coming in for North, but well done there by the Tigers. The hand pass came out off the bottom of the pack by Snook. Kick around the corner from Weir. McBean, he tackled his North Adelaide opponent, who didn't have the footy, and the free kick will go the way of Ben Jarman. So the boy from Foss Camden, he's got Smith
everywhere
in some space. They can spread now, the Roosters. Tanner Smith from Kalki kicks inside the centre of Prospect Oval, inside 50. Looking down there for a teammate, and Parks has taken the mark. And Hender, well, he was going to play on. Parks for mine did step off the line, and Hender's given away a 25.
Interesting call there, but he's been really steady back there today. Luke Parks playing yet another exceptional game in defence for Glenelg.
It's been an absolute rock down there, and he chips short and finds Callum Park.
Marlon Motlop back onto the ground for Glenelg. Looks a little bit proppy, but he's come back on.
It's in the hands now of Luke Reynolds, who's 55 from defensive goal. Down there in the Prospect cricket pocket, down the left.
He's certainly taking his time.
As the Roosters faithful, wanting the umpire to call play on, and they do so now. Kicks down the line, coming off the side of the pack was Condon, and the aforementioned Marlon Motlop escorts it over the line.
Not one player forward of the half for Glenelg. Liam McBean just trotting back there now with Cam Craig, but very much flooding and hoping to cling on here, Glenelg.
25 gone in the final term. How much time is left? Coming through Allman. Is he taken high? Nothing. Doing a lot of numbers around the footy. Who wants the ball? Coming through Glenelg, that Partington. Just jams it on the boot. Passy smothered some numbers. Should win out for North. Good hand pass from Miller. Off to Allman. Gets on the left boot, but a smother was brilliant there from Reynolds.
Outstanding. We know what a quality forward Luke Reynolds is, but geez, defensively he's showing off some tricks now.
He's playing that loose behind the play, and he's affected what could potentially be a game-saving smother. So left just forward pocket.
Watch for Ben Jarman here. He's in plenty of space at centre forward for North.
A shallow throw in. Stretch taken. He was legged in a tackle. So a free kick going the way of the Tigers. Alex Spina, the captain of North Adelaide, giving it away. So 26 gone now, final term. A two-point ball game. Glenelg kicking down to the Robron or Southern end. And they have the ball at half-back grandstand side with Billy Stretch. Stretch kicks down the line, looking for a teammate, but Schwarz, the North Adelaide player, intercepts. He'll roll along quickly, aware of the time, goes inside 50. Parks spoils from behind. Slade there, gives it off now to Scharenberg. A hand pass, a kick around the corner. Flying Moore couldn't take it. Coming through Chalmers. Is he clean in the possession? No. He was clumsy in the tackle, and he went high on his opponent in Allen.
And just as you say that, Phil, the one-minute sign is now being held up by Glenelg's bench, so we're less than a minute, I would have thought.
About to tick into the 27-minute mark. The ball in the hands there of Matt Allen. He'll kick down the line. McBean will fly early. Hanneth will see it out the back. First there, James Craig. The big fella's got Jarman in some space. The kick, a dangerous one. Glenelg can turn it over. Coming through Partington. He's got Bailey in some space. Inside 50. Now to McBean. Can the Tigers seal it? Over the top for McBean. The ball didn't bounce for him. And there goes the siren. Drama at Prospect. Glenelg hang on in a thriller. 27 minutes gone in the final term. And Glenelg hang on, 10-11-71. North Adelaide, 10-9-69. Heartbreak for the Roosters, a thriller at Prospect. And what a great game of footy it was. A great advertisement, Zach Milbank, for the SANFL Statewide Super League.
Keeps on giving, doesn't it, Phil? That was just a tremendous game of Statewide Super League footy. Just had everything, didn't it? Glenelg sort of getting control of the contest earlier in the day. North Adelaide...